say live for this year's Miss Commonwealth.
This year's prestigious pageant is being held at the Hammersmith Palais in London.
It really would need it. That is very important.
I mean, in the 5 dressing rooms that we've got, we've got mirrors in each.
It's a week before the event, and there's a lot of work to be done.
And then leave yourself and me just to work through the actual optional logistics of the event.
I think we'll come to that, but we needed to meet these people here today.
Hey, my name is Ndaba Mandela. I'm here on behalf of my grandfather, Nelson Mandela.
It's 2 p.m. and the girls are busy rehearsing before the big day.
And look at behind me, look at all these glorious women, and they've travelled from afar. So girls, tell me where you've come from.
I'm from Slovakia. I'm a friend of Miss Commonwealth.
And yourself?
The Bahamas.
Lovely, nice and summer weather.
From Oxford in England.
London.
Pakistan.
Devon in England.
I'm Miss Somalia.
India.
Miss Guyana.
So there you have it, we have women from all over the Commonwealth joining us here live tomorrow for the competition final of Miss Commonwealth 2006.
He's called me this morning and asked me to do today. Whether I'll do tomorrow, it might be better if I did do tomorrow, obviously, because I've done it now. But I don't know.
We have to wait.
You have to see till tomorrow. But he'll be fantastic, whatever. He's brilliant, so I won't worry about him. I think you need to ask whoever's in charge, I don't know.
I don't ask you if it's a problem for you, switch sides.
Does anyone know what time they're here tomorrow?
2 p.m. tomorrow.
Yes.
2 p.m.
Yeah.
Huh? Yeah, it's going to be everything tomorrow. And can everybody, if you're not staying in the hotel, you need to be on time. Right, we don't want nobody coming in at 2:30, 3:00, 4:00. It will not be accepted. 2 p.m. tomorrow. That's the time.
So
there's a lot to go through tomorrow.
Yeah.
So you need to be here on time. Yeah? And tomorrow everybody trains in their heels. Right? No flat shoes, heels. Make sure you have your heels with you.
Know what they're doing.
We've been given a script now.
Oh, lovely.
Yes. So
right.
We need to go away and actually just digest it, to be honest with you.
Okay, my lovely.
But
I
know what we're doing and I know what I'm saying, but there's also an extension to this, but we won't have it till
tomorrow.
Or maybe later today. I don't think so.
Well, it might be better that you speak to Wayne about what you two do.
Absolutely, because we want to know our
Wayne's
positioning.
Not here. Exactly. And what I was going to do is have you two maybe coming on there and standing there.
Yeah.
And then you standing over there.
Yeah.
So you're split sides.
Well, I'm a host.
Yeah.
This
is what's going to be happening. So I am going to be presenting, so therefore there'll be two of us, not Jessica, myself and another girl will be presenting.
So you'll be split.
Either side.
And they introduce the host, myself and Jeff.
That's right.
And then we walk on, but we don't know where we're standing to on the stage.
Right. Now, I've just been told that there might be a walkway.
Yeah, that's correct. I was told there may be a walkway.
So
it's live television. It happens like this every single time.
So do you think we'll be standing at the beginning of the walkway?
Until I know if there is a walkway, there's not really much point thinking about that, really. So.
Absolutely.
I mean, as long as I know where I'm coming out of, where I'm going to position myself,
exactly.
I'm completely fine. As long as I've got some lovely gentlemen holding my arm to make sure I don't trip over my lovely, stunning
exactly.
long dress, then
exactly.
I'll be fine. I just want a good-looking
with me. I think it might be easier when tomorrow to set you guys, because all you've got to
absolutely.
Do is stand somewhere. It's not like you've got to have to do a walk down as well.
Mm.
So as long as by tomorrow, this is all set and this is all set up. When they start doing it, then Wayne can put you in. Now, if I'm here tomorrow, I'll do it.
Mm-hmm.
But until I know if I'm here tomorrow, I can't really say.
But on a serious note, can you find me a good-looking gentleman to
yes.
carry me down the stairs?
I'm actually just going to talk to the contestants and see how they're feeling, if they're nervous, if they're looking forward to the show. So, ladies, welcome. How do you feel about the show?
I'm looking forward to it. I think it's a great opportunity to have like a good platform to be able to promote a lot of like charitable work, and
mm-hmm.
at the same time you meet lots of You meet lots of nice people from all over the different countries.
And what's your name?
My name is Nidhima. I'm representing India.
Uh-huh.
So, yes, I hope it will go really well. And I've made, like, friends from Bahama and, like, from New Zealand and stuff. It's really, really nice. And I hope to be able to use this title and be an ambassador for my country to promote lots of charitable work.
Thank you very much. We're going to just go over here and grab this lovely lady here. I'm one of the presenters for the show.
Yeah.
How do you feel? Are you nervous?
A little bit nervous, but once rehearsals are over and we know what we're doing, then I'll be happy and
you're representing what country?
Devon in England.
Woo!
Yeah.
Are you confident?
I've got some confidence, but I'm just here to enjoy it, and it's really nice meeting people from all different countries, and I'm looking forward to seeing all the different cultural dresses and displays.
Good luck.
Thank
see
you very
you
much.
Tomorrow. Thank you. Hello. Hi, my name's Sky. Lovely to meet you. What's your name?
Nida. Alia.
And what are you representing?
I'm going to be representing Pakistan.
Wow, are you confident?
Yeah, I am actually. I was a bit nervous about it at first, but now that I've got to meet everyone, and it's quite nice. I mean, it doesn't really matter who wins. It's just nice to meet a whole lot of new people from different countries.
Well, what would you like to promote within the show? Is there anything, any personal attributes or, you know, from a personal point of view that you would like to...
Basically, I don't think I've seen many people do anything from Pakistan, like the cultural outfit and everything else. So, I mean, I feel really honoured to be able to go out and present something like that.
Well done.
That's why I want to do it.
How do you feel the rehearsals are going? Are you feeling confident with the rehearsals? Are you sure what you know what's going on? Do you feel confident with the stage? How do you feel? You looked a bit nervous earlier, so I thought I'd grab you.
Before I was nervous, but I've done modelling before. I mean, I model quite a lot actually, catwalks and stuff. Mm-hmm. I didn't know what was going on at first, but now that I do know what's going on and I know what I'm doing, I feel a lot more confident.
Good. Well, that's just an idea of how the contestants are feeling, and I'm going to grab one more lady who's been trying to hide away from me. This lady here, come here.
Be honest.
What's your name? And you're very tall. Oh my Hi. God. What's your name?
It's Akal Francesca Blacaris.
Say that slowly.
Okay. Akal Francesca Blacaris.
Wow, I will not even attempt to say that. What country are you representing?
The Commonwealth of the Bahamas.
Well done. How are you feeling?
Well, I'm confident, but I was expecting it to be more of a prestigious pageant, but I'm getting used to it.
Say that again. You're expecting it to be
more prestigious?
Right, yes, okay.
It's not what I expected, but I'm getting used to it.
Tell us a little bit about what you're going to be wearing tomorrow, because of course, with ladies, women, they love clothes, they love hair. What's your dress going to be like?
Well, it's a design by a Bahamian designer, very famous, Cedric Bernard. It's inspired by one of our birds, mm-hmm. Peacock.
The peacock?
Yes.
So it's from Bahamas?
Yes.
Right.
Also, I'll be wearing our Bahamian national wear.
Sorry to interrupt you.
Sure.
When you say one of our birds, is that part of your
symbol?
Yes. Hello. And here we have Dr. Patrick, who is one of the main organisers for Miss Commonwealth. This
You're
is Dr.
Well.
Patrick's
You're
and... Thank you very much. Just wanted a quick word with you. How are you feeling? You look stressed.
I'm very stressed.
Are you?
And after this show, I'm going to sleep for 2 weeks.
After this
non-stop,
show,
yeah.
I think you should go on holiday.
I'll do that as well, yeah.
But any major hiccups, everything going smoothly?
Well, we might have a few hiccups.
But I'm sure you're
we'll
going to be
them.
Handling
we'll
them.
Them.
You're
yeah.
resolving
yeah.
them.
Yeah. Yeah.
Great. Looking well, forward to the show?
Absolutely.
Oh, great. Well, the
That's
girls the are happy.
Yeah,
the girls are
all.
Happy. Everything's going smooth.
Shalina, I'm representing Malaysia in this Miss Commonwealth. I am a veterinary surgeon, and also I'm currently pursuing my master's in veterinary science. And that's it, I guess.
Now, there were a lot of girls that entered this competition. Were you surprised that you've got this far?
This is actually, I'm only a finalist, you know, we've not gotten that far yet. I'm hoping to go far with it, you know, along as we'll see how we'll go along.
Okay, now this is quite a big event. It's broadcast to many countries all over the Commonwealth. Are you feeling quite nervous, or are you sort of quite excited, or how are you feeling at the moment, one day before the event?
Okay, this is my first time abroad actually, in UK, and entering a pageant in UK is a big thing, and I'm very, very excited, happy, and also of course a bit nervous, but I'm enjoying the experience so far, and that is the big thing, you know, that is the main thing. I'm here for the exposure and the experience.
Hello, I'm Jemima Douglas, and I'm representing Trinidad and Tobago for Miss Commonwealth International 2006.
Christina, representing Miss Guyana in the teen category.
Okay, so what are you looking to get from this competition?
I'm hoping to represent my country and hopefully win, and yeah, I'll just make my country win something for once, which is Guyana.
Okay. Now, it is quite a responsibility being a pageant. If you win, you know, you'll be asked to kind of go to ceremonies, represent charities and be a good ambassador. I mean, are you looking forward to that at all?
Yeah, I think I'll be good at doing stuff like that, interacting with people and stuff, so yeah.
You have got to remember that yourselves. You can't come up to me or Wayne tomorrow and say, I don't know what I'm doing.
I've just forgotten what...
But do you see what I'm saying? I mean, I've been through it 3 or 4 times now, and you've done it in your lunchtime. You need to know exactly what you're doing tomorrow. You need to come in here and you need to know your stuff, okay? Yes, Sammy!
Thank you, Sammy!
Okay.
Thank you, Sammy. See you tomorrow, Sammy.
See you tomorrow.
Sheesh. It's all just bombarding.
It's coming.
I want to be vain and upset, but I can't do it.
Hello, this is Fiona. I'm from Kenya. I'm coming to participate in the Miss Commonwealth 2006.
And then to the interview of the finalists of Miss Teen. That will be followed by photo entertainment by Claire. And there will be the crowning of the Miss Teen winner and runner-up. There will be photo interviews, this time of the finalists of the Misses Commonwealth.
This year's pageant has had several sponsors, including African Central Productions, Buffalo City Municipality, Copy World, the South African Department of Sports, Recreation, Arts and Culture, Family Favourite, IDC, SABC TV and Radio, SA Guests Wheel 17 and Kiba Clover.
Hi, my name is Arshina Trivedi and I'm representing Miss Teen India.
Hi, Ashina. So how did you get involved in the competition?
Just asked me to take part, send in my application, and I did, and here I am.
Now, there were a lot of girls that entered this competition. Were you surprised that you've got this far to the grand final?
Because, there are, as you said, lots of people taking part, and, quite surprised.
Being Miss Commonwealth is quite a responsibility. As well as winning the pageant, you're also going to be an ambassador for charities. You'll be a role model for young people in schools, etc., all over the world. Are you ready for that responsibility? Do you think you can take that challenge?
Well, I have done quite a lot of charity work before for organisations, and I have put on a sort of stage performance and raised money for charity. So, I'm ready for it. Bring it all on.
I think the main thing is
It is charitable at the end of the day and not commercialised like a Miss World, but none of them... I've already seen lots of beautiful girls around, so it's also giving your time, giving their time up. I just think they've already achieved so much to, you know, raise funds, meet, you know, like, I've, so interesting for me to meet girls from other countries, which you don't tend to see day in, day out. Making friends, learning about the country, and yes, if, as Dr. Triggs did explain, it's only a new event, so like anything, nothing's really perfect, so you need, it gets better and better and better as the years go along. And I do believe that the Friends of the Commonwealth Queen contest is the first in its kind. So for me, I'm very lucky that I was able to enter, because it's giving women of all ages, all backgrounds, a chance to compete. So it's not like saying, one day a woman saying, oh gosh, I wish I was, when I was 18, I should have entered a contest. Now we've got the flexibility, different kinds of competitions, women from all other ages, and, you know, learning from the young and learning from the, you know, the the older members of the the pageant.
18 women in that title. It's worth it. We've done well out of it, and we have
made
money from that.
Well,
the winners are saying it's worth it.
We have lots of people out of our title. That was our prize, our title.
So you got the question?
And you will.
She's reassured me a little bit better, so.
We wouldn't come back, sadly.
Pardon?
Who? She got nothing last time. She's earned a lot through it. She's been on TV adverts, you know, she's met famous people. She's had a wonderful time.
Today's rehearsals, one day before the big event. How are you feeling? Are you nervous, excited?
Not nervous. A little bit excited, because I'm looking forward to know what's going to happen tomorrow, because we don't really know how it's going to be. We've got a little like schedule, but... You know, schedules don't always run, if you get
me. Apprehensive, I don't know. I'm not nervous, it's a bit of excitement. Because this is the first time I'm ever doing like a pageant or anything like as big as this, like in my whole life. So it's just an experience for me. I'm just gonna take each day as it comes.
Okay, I'm here with Jennifer and Emma. I'm just gonna speak to these girls and find out how they got involved with the event.
I got involved with the competition because I have a charity. I started back at home and I wanted to come and do the competition because it deals with charity and volunteering. So, and because I like to volunteer myself to help people, to help children, that's why I came here for that.
Emma. Obviously, there are other pageants as well, like Miss World and Miss Universe. What makes this one different from you?
For me, basically, it's the charity part of the event. And it's sort of a different set out. They've said they're mainly working for charities, and especially for Commonwealth countries. I'm originally from Zambia. I live in Zambia as well. And I do work with AIDS and HIV often on the education part, and I do do charity events, raising money. We've got an adopted orphanage in Zambia, so I do work with that, and I thought this is a good way of using this title. At the moment, I do make money, but it's not enough at the end of the day, so I thought being a Miss Commonwealth would be bigger than being Miss Zambia, and I will use that title to raise more money for the orphans that I raise money for in Zambia, and making it broader and wider, as in all to the other Commonwealth countries as well.
Speak to some of the girls that have entered the contest for Miss Commonwealth. Hello, girls.
Hello.
Hello. Okay. So, girls, you've done really well to get this far. Obviously, a lot of girls entered this competition, and you're now down to the final stage. How are you feeling at the moment? Are you excited? Nervous? How are you feeling?
Well, I'm tired, and I just can't wait for tomorrow to come so it can be all over and done with. But I'm confident.
Usually with pageants you think everyone is sort of very sort of catty and very private and competitive. There seems to be a good atmosphere between the girls. Does that surprise you at all?
we've all got to know each other pretty well today, just because we're all sort of in the same boat, a bit stressed, a bit apprehensive. Met some really good people through it. That's probably the best thing today.
Hi, this is Shanna, one of the contestants in the competition. I'm just going to speak to her about what this competition means to her. Hiya. So if you won Miss Commonwealth, what would it mean to you?
Yeah, it would mean a lot to me if I won Miss Teen Commonwealth. I'm running for the teen competition. It would help me with my passion. I love the young people. Okay. I just want to help those in need.
Okay, now today's the big day and the girls are all in their hotel rooms getting ready to go, so let's go and take a look.
My name is Maria Chippendale. I'm participating as Mrs. Commonwealth South Africa. And it's a question that everybody asks me the whole last 3 days is, why are you doing this? For me, I believe it will be absolutely awesome for my country should I be able to take the title, and I believe it's about timing. And it is so amazing, the team that we've got here. We've got Miss Commonwealth South Africa and Miss Teen Commonwealth South Africa. And we've got Ndaba Mandela, that is Nelson Mandela's grandson, that's accepting an award for him tonight. That is so powerful. It's so amazing. And it is such an experience to be here. All the culturals, all the different Commonwealth countries, and we talk about culture, we're talking about charities, we're talking about where we can go with Commonwealth. For me personally, should I be able to take the crown, I would like to empower women. I'm a motivational speaker in South Africa. I specialize in hyperthyroidism. In the layman's term, we call it underactive thyroid. And there's thousands and thousands of women, especially in the African countries, that doesn't even know what this disease is all about. And where we can go with this, the empowerment, just to explain to them about the symptoms and the treatment. It's such an easy, solvable problem with very inexpensive medication. But the problem is that they don't know about it. And that's my job. That's where I want to go.
My name is Ndaba Mandela. I'm here on behalf of my grandfather, Nelson Mandela, to accept an award for some humanitarian services. I think definitely it's the most important part of pageants, you know, also just getting everybody together to have build friendly relations and also put the ladies on a pedestal whereby they can get into do other things, you know, promote themselves and help other people in need through the charity work that they do.
That's gonna be too big. How many? What luggage have you got? I think that luggage is going to be too much. What we need is somebody that got small luggage. We can't have people that have got the big luggage.
Hello, my name's Patsy White. I'm one of the organisers for Miss Commonwealth International 2006. And I'm here, I'm looking after all the contestants who have come from far and wide to be here. It's very challenging for me. There are loads of women and they're all gorgeous, and the judges, I feel sorry for you because I don't know who you're going to choose to win this pageant. We've got a very full day today because we'll be leaving in a minute to go down and have our rehearsals, and then from there the pageant will begin later this evening. We know that we've got some very important people coming to see the pageant, and I know the pageant will be a success.
My name is Brenda Bessel. I'm one of the judges invited here for the Miss Commonwealth International.
Hi, Brenda. Right, you're obviously a former model yourself, and you've got lots of experience in the industry. This event itself is a good launch pad for some of the girls. Do you have any advice for them at all?
I think what many girls have to realise is that it's actually a good opportunity for them to actually use it as a stepping stone for a career. Either, you know, for the community or whatever they want to aspire. all they need to know is that, you know, from here it's like a stepping stone. Enjoy it, you know, when the going's good. I mean, obviously you have highs and lows, and as far as I'm concerned, you know, everyone's a winner regardless of whatever, you know, whatever criteria.
Hello everyone, I'm Fiona Akum, representing Kenya in the Miss Commonwealth 2006.
Hello Miss Kenya.
Hello.
Hello. So, how have you found the experience so far? Today's the big day. Do you feel prepared to go on stage and do what you have to do?
I have to say it's been a short while. I just came yesterday and I had 1 day to prepare, but it's lovely. I've had a lovely day. London is beautiful and I think I'm ready for the stage. Yeah, I'm ready for anything.
You know what? I got Starbucks. If you fight up unless you wonder, you not get any. I said, water, no get any. You not get any. If you fight up unless you wonder, you not get any. Where will you go?
Welcome to the Hammersmith Palais. I'm here today live for this year's Miss Commonwealth 2006.
This is the before.
Yeah.
Hopefully we won't be like this after.
So what's happening now, girls? What are you doing here?
We're just waiting now for our hair and makeup artists to arrive, and then we're going to get ready then for the show.
Well, we've got the presenter Sky here. We're doing Sky's hair and makeup. We've got Miss Malta here.
Miss Teen.
And Mrs. And Miss the whole Malta crew here. And Miss South Africa. Yeah. And I've got Lucy, makeup and hairstylist here.
Hello.
So everything is going really well.
My name is Jeff Schumann. I am hosting the Miss Commonwealth International. I'm so excited, I'm mumbling my words. I'm really looking forward to it. It's a prestigious Triple Teen Crown Awards location. The organisers have no expense spared. We're really looking forward to it. And as far as I'm concerned, this is creme de la creme. This is going to be the mother of all beauty talent contests. Of course, they've got me, Usher, Denzel Washington lookalike, being the host this evening. So hopefully I'll use some wit, use some charm and veracity to try and make the event run smooth.
Okay, now Madonna, you know you are my best friend, okay? And as you do know, I haven't even met my co-host yet.
He's at the back.
Is Jeff at the back?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. It probably would be, or should I just surprise him on stage?
Should we go and...
I think you should see him.
I should. Whereabouts is he?
All right.
Hello.
Hi, what's happening? How are you?
So it's been a great uplifting experience for me, career-wise.
Are there any courses that are quite close to your heart that you'd like to promote or work with?
Yes, children in poverty and also like child labour, like in developing countries. That's something that's really close to my heart. I visited Moldova, which is the poorest country in Europe, last year with a youth group, and we saw sort of the effects that child labour can have on children. I mean, there were children just out working on the street and they were like literally four and they had nothing. And that's in Europe, and you just would never have a clue that that kind of poverty went on in this continent, let alone in others. So I'd like to be able to have the power to be able to do more about that actively to try and eradicate that.
Hi, I'm Krisha, and I am completely crazy, but it's all madness that is Miss Commonwealth. It's all good. It's going to be a fabulous evening, and everything's going to be fun, fun, fun all the way. All good. It's going to be a fabulous evening. and everything's going to be fun all the way.
Sean, how is it going?
It's going, trying to get it all together. This is my catering queen, Sonia.
Hi.
Nicola.
Hello.
Kimmy. Vanna. And
Hi, I'm Zoe Jameson-Smith from XX Entertainment. I run an entertainment company and I'm here helping to organise the event. So watch and enjoy, it's going to be great.
Which come on, Cheshire? Mrs. Commonwealth, oh, she's not here, Ghana.
Ghana. Mrs. Ghana.
Mrs. 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 Mrs.
I think you're going to take it forever.
Commonwealth, Bahamas, team.
Bashana! Here you go.
How's it going?
It's going okay, just so much to wear African dresses.
Hi, my name is Claudia Henkel and I'm participating in the Miss Commonwealth. I think that it's been, for me, it's my first time to London, so I've had an incredible time. I think that part of being in this industry is looking after yourself and fending for yourself, and also, you know, arranging things and not, you know, requiring them to do everything all the time. And that I've learned. We've caught taxis on our own, and for me, it's been a great experience.
So, what do you think your chances are? Because I think you have a very strong chance.
Oh, thank you.
I do.
No, I've been part of, you know, the modeling industry and the entertainment industry, and you have to basically say to yourself that it's not up to what you've done, because you can only try your best, but it's what the judges look for. And maybe today they look for a blonde, maybe tomorrow they look for an African, maybe tomorrow they look for the day after a brunette. So I think it just depends on how they're feeling tonight, and you know, who I honestly believe in, the best girl should win. So if a girl stands out and she looks great, then I think the crowd should go to her. This is a backdrop which I hold up, and basically what it is, it just describes South Africa in all our, you know, our varieties, our diversity. It ranges from the Ndebele hats at the bottom, right up to, you know, the different kind of people, and there's Mandela Bridge, and the different aquarium life, and the mountains, and different typography, and I think it's just a complete show of what South Africa is made of and how diverse we are. I think it's a great, great, great painting. It was actually designed by students for the Miss Universe competition, and I brought it here because I think it's so relevant in terms of this competition and the Miss Commonwealth.
Ndaba Mandela, grandson of Nelson Mandela, is at the event to pick up an award.
This is the first time that South Africa has been allowed to enter this competition. How important is it for South Africa to have a presence at this event?
I think it's very important for them to be able to build relations with all the fellow Commonwealth countries, and it will also give them a pedestal whereby they can promote themselves and really go out there and do some good work with the charity which I involve, etc. South Africa all the way.
Which one in particular?
Which one in particular? I'm actually triple crown all the way. Miss Teen, Miss and Mrs. South Africa all the way.
Yeah. I am Alafair Celestine from Trinidad and Tobago, and I'm the reigning Miss Commonwealth International. Today, I will be crowning the new Miss Commonwealth International 2006. Good. Tell us,
Miss Commonwealth International, how has it been reigning as the first ever Triple Crown culture and charity beauty queen? And what a difference has that made in your life?
Okay, it's a great opportunity to be crowned Miss Commonwealth International. The title itself is a great privilege and a great prestige to be part of the Commonwealth community. I'm coming from Trinidad and Tobago, but I represent all the Commonwealth countries, and it has been a really wonderful experience, a life-changing experience for me, getting adopted to the UK lifestyle, because I've made the UK my home now in London. And since I've won, I've been able to do so many things with the title in terms of charitable and non-charitable organizations. I've been able to develop my skills and talents as a presenter. It also afforded me to do numerous magazines, meeting dignitaries, doing television interviews and so forth. So it's been a great uplifting experience for me career-wise.
As Miss Commonwealth International, what advice would you give to the many hopeful Miss Commonwealth participants?
Okay, well, my advice is basically simple. It's just for them to be themselves. I mean, they have different categories to model today, which is swimwear, casual wear, evening wear, the gong, the traditional wear. It's just to be at ease, be confident, be positive, try to be relaxed, and just keep smiling. Enjoy the experience, because it's one in a lifetime.
A dance group are also performing at tonight's show.
Ladies,
hi.
Now I know you've been busy, lots of girls to look beautiful. Can you tell me how many contestants have you been working on today?
Oh gosh, there's so many. There's so many too. I think there must be about 80. And these are all my hair and makeup team. And we just try and get their cultural makeup and hair. Basically, the look was, we wanted to give them a really glamorous red carpet look. Make them look like themselves, a very natural, fresh, glowing face. And they all look very beautiful and very glamorous. Smoky eyes, very, very stunning. And thank you for my team. We used makeups from MAC, Bobbi Brown, YSL, L'Oreal, hair products, and they all look stunning. I'm sure you agree.
They do look
stunning. These are the lovely crowns.
So I know the winners are going to be happy when they have these on their head.
Just take a look at this. Look how they're glistening, look how they're glittering. Look how lovely they are. This one is very American, this big one here. It's very American, but I think the winner will appreciate it. And I actually want to see what it looks like on her head. Because I know it wouldn't fit on mine. Mine's too big.
This is the son of Dr. Nelson Mandela. And come on, a round of applause for that. He's been over 20 years, 27 years in prison for you.
It's a great honor and a great pleasure to accept this award on behalf of my grandfather, who unfortunately was unable to make it. Thank you very much.
The Ivies Awards represents the International Voluntary, Humanitarian and Environmental Services. It is voted for by the international community and commends contribution to charitable causes.
I just wanted to grab your attention to tell you more about what this event is all about. It's about bringing together all the Commonwealth countries in a unified spirit to promote cultural awareness and charitableness. Charitableness, common good, and peace between all the Commonwealth countries, not only to ourselves, but to the rest of the world as a whole.
Okay. This pageant has brought together Commonwealth citizens from Africa, Asia Pacific, the Caribbean, and Euro-Atlantic to promote good causes. Now, as you will all have known already, the pageant has raised over £3 million for charities around the world. Since its first staging of the contest in November 2004 in Liverpool. Now, isn't that an amazing amount for a young pageant?
Yes.
Just think how much more it will raise as it gets older and better and bigger.
If you could do me a favour, if you could turn to someone who you don't know and just say hello. Even if you have to wait, let's create an atmosphere, let's create a vibe. Turn to someone you don't know, shake some hands, we're here for a prestigious occasion. Let's at least amongst ourselves attempt to create some kind of atmosphere, some ambience in this particular arena. Jessica, good evening to you. Having just seen the script, distinguished ladies, guests, and of course, gentlemen, we want to say, before we bring out the ladies, people have traveled far and wide for this momentous and prestigious occasion. Let me firstly tell you about this particular evening. The selection and coronation of the 2006 Class of Culture and Charity Queens of the Commonwealth vested with the following prestigious international coronation titles. Tonight, Jess, we crown Miss Commonwealth International 2006, Miss Teen Commonwealth International 2006, I've got Miss Commonwealth Culture International 2006, Miss Commonwealth Charity International 2006, Miss Commonwealth Africa 2006, Miss Commonwealth Asia Pacific, Miss Commonwealth Caribbean, and Miss Commonwealth Euro-Atlantic. The London Triple Crown Culture and Charity Pageant. This will produce Miss Commonwealth London, as I said earlier, Miss Teen Commonwealth London, and Mrs. Commonwealth London for the increased promotion of community charitableness and cultural awareness, of course, within cosmopolitan London. Now, the London Triple Crown 2012 will add tremendous colour to the London Olympics, which are coming here in 2012. And why not? After all, London is the capital of the Commonwealth's headquarters.
Oh!
see yourself. You can't save for them and not for wealth.
You can't truly bless and not bless the good of all. You can't serve the rich and desert the poor. You can't hear the cries and just close your door.
You can't say you're down and not take it to the wall. You can't benefit from one's detriment. You can't find the serum and not kill the sick.
You can't free the slaves to enslave them differently. You can't see the right only from your side. You can't see the wrong and just go along.
Or is that the way you would want your fate to be?
International 2006. Miss Teen is Miss Bahama. Absolutely fantastic. Please be careful. We don't want nothing to drop off now, please. I mean the crowd, Miss Bahama. Was it close? In fact, it was points that decided this one. Pika Masko, how dare you? Okay, ladies and gents, in third place was Miss India! There we go again. Stand there, please. In second place was Miss Ghana Culture! And the winner of Miss Commonwealth 2006. Get undressed.
I do know about the two showers you had, the cold ones. I do know about that, you know.
And I have put a team out for cardiac resuscitation for you.
Mum, she's lying. I only have eyes for you. Ladies and gents, good night. God bless. On behalf of the organisers, thank you very much for coming out. Thank you very much for being so patient. And hopefully we'll see you somewhere in a venue in 2007. Good night. God bless. And may your gods go with you. Thank you. Good night.
She came here and she says she was going to win the competition. Well, I thought, really? Okay, good luck to you. And you know what? She's leaving here and she's won the Mrs. Commonwealth. And that is Mrs. South Africa.
Yes, thank you.
Well done,
thanks,
baby.
Very much. Well done, thank very you. Much. Are you really pleased with the result? Of course
absolutely.
You would be.
And we are.
It was fantastic. I came here to win, you're right.
Yeah.
I had a focus and I tried to focus on the focus. It was difficult, but I'm so excited landing in South Africa with this crown because it was the first time that South Africa was invited to participate in this pageant.
Really?
And we took it the first time.
Right.
And we are taking a win home, so it's fantastic. Thank you very much.
What's your name?
My name is Roshanna Thompson.
Say that slowly, babe.
Roshanna Thompson.
And well done, you won the competition. That's fantastic.
Thank you.
What did you take away with you from this competition? You know, from the actual event itself?
From the actual event itself, I took away a lot of friendships and a lot of confidence, self-confidence within myself.
Now we have the winner of Miss Commonwealth. None other than... And I know her quite well. Well done. None other than Miss Bahamas. Here we have Miss Bahamas. Well done.
Thank you.
That was amazing. Confident, together, to the point, and you carried it off. Because you won.
Yes.
How do you feel?
Wow, I feel ecstatic right now. I'm still trying to soak it all in. Wow. And this is the first international crown for my country.
Exactly.
So I'm really excited.
Yeah.
You say your name. Oh, look, you'd rather stay alive.